हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज वीडियो ऑफ क्लास 8 चैप्टर 1 दैट इज रेशनल नंबर। ओके, इन दिस सेक्शन वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द रेशनल नंबर, व्हाट इज रेशनल नंबर एंड रिलेटेड टू द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ अ रेशनल नंबर। ओके, नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज नंबर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दैट नंबर इज 1, 2, 3, 4 लाइक दैट। ओके, सो सम डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ नंबर यू विल सी in these chapters or in previous classes. So there is need of understanding that we need to understand that what is rational number, what is related to the rational numbers. Okay, so first of all come to the number. Number is what? As you know, number is what we can say 1, 2, 3, these are the numbers. No, and now these are the parts of number. Numbers are divided in two parts, that is real number and the another one is imaginary number. Okay, what is imaginary number? Imaginary number is some type of complex number, and in this chapter you don't need to study about the imaginary number. Okay, so let's move on to the real number. What is real number? Real number, here is also two type of real number. One is rational number and the another one is irrational number. Okay, rational number and the irrational number, these are difference between the rational and irrational is only that, like in rational number, fractions, integers, the numbers which we will study, that is our rational number, or the number which is not rational, that is irrational. Okay, like if we will write root 3, root 5, these are irrational number. Okay, and now come to the rational number. This is our main topic which we have to study in this chapter. So more focus, you have to do more focus on that topic, that is rational number. Okay, so the two parts of the rational number is fractions and integer. What is fraction? Fraction, you have studied that if we will write 1/2, 3/4, these terms can be say that these are in fraction. Okay, where p and q, these terms are in form of p by q. Okay, wherever q is not equal to 0. Okay, so this kind of number is fraction, is fractional number, as we can say. Now come to the integer. Integer is what? There are two types of integer. One thing is positive and the another one is negative integer. So negative integer, we will know that in negative integer, what is negative integer? If we say about -1, -2, -13, these are negative integer. The number which are negative, that is our negative integer or negative number, we can say. And another one is positive, or also you can say whole number, or also positive number. Okay, positive number. So what is a positive number? That is 1, 2, 3, 4. These are our positive number. Okay? There is also two type of positive number or whole number, you can say. That is what? One thing is 0 and the another one is natural number. The number which concludes only 0, that is our 0 number. And the number which concludes natural number, that is our natural number, that is also positive numbers. Okay, like 1, 2 we are writing, these are our natural number, and 0 is only 0. Okay, now we will study about rational number, the definition of rational number. Okay, what is the definition of rational number? The number which is in form of p by q, where q is not is equals to 0, that number we can say is rational number. The number which is in form of p by q, or we can say in form of fraction, that is our rational number. Okay, and now example is 1/3, -2/5, 3/4, 0 by 1, whatever it is. Okay, but one thing you have to focus that the Q must be not equal to 0. Okay, Q will never be equal to 0. Now next, the parts of the rational number is what? Positive number. Positive number. There are two types of rational number, that is positive number and the another one is negative number. In positive number, a rational number, is said to be positive number if there is a condition. A rational number is said to be positive number if P and Q both are positive or both negative. Okay, this is our condition. Any of the rational number, we can say that this is a positive number. On which condition? If P and Q both are positive or both negative. Like some examples, minus 3 by minus 5, minus 2 by minus 3, 4 by 5, these are our positive numbers. Okay, similarly, the negative number, second topic is negative number. This is our second part. Negative number, a rational number, in same way of positive number, a rational number is said to be negative number if its numerator or denominator are of opposite sign. Okay, numerator and denominator are of opposite sign. Okay, so examples of negative number is what? Minus 3 by 5, minus 2 by minus 4, like this, minus 1 by 7. Here we can see 3 is in negative and 5 is in positive. That means the denominator is positive, the numerator is negative. The numerator is positive here and the denominator is negative here. The numerator is negative here and the denominator is positive here. So these numbers are, we can say, a negative number, or this kind of rational number we can say a negative numbers. These are the some properties of rational number. Okay, so we have to study that properties of rational number. There are three properties of rational number. First one is that if a fraction number is in form of A by B, okay, or you will write it is in form of P by Q, whatever. Some integers, if we are multiplying in both the numerator and denominator, where M is some integer. Okay, so now we we are multiplying some integer, that is m, in both p and q, both the numerator and denominator, then we got what?
We got
some equivalent rational number. Okay, like some examples. 2 by 5 we have. And now I am going to multiply here some integer. Like m is equals to 4. Now I am going to multiply with 4 in both the numerator and denominator. We got what? 8 by 20. Okay, so this is equivalent rational number of 2 by 5. So 8 by 20 is equivalent rational number. Okay, and next we can also find on an integer, like negative integer. This one is positive integer. Okay, let us sum negative integer -2, and now 2 by 5, and we are multiplying some negative integer in both the p and q, in both the 2 and 5 of this kind of rational number. So we got what? -4 by -10. So this is equivalent rational number of 2 by 5. Okay, that is -4 by -10. Now our next property is 30, and some rational number p by q we have taken. Okay, and in this one, what we have to do? We have to divide some integers. Like we are taking m is some integer here. M is some integer. Okay. So now we will divide both the numerator and denominator. One numerator and denominator from that integer. And now in this one, what we are doing? That we have taken some integers m, and we are dividing both the numerator and denominator. So most one thing is important that you have to notice, that if we are applying some integers, we are dividing or we are multiplying, we need to do in both the numerator and denominator. Okay. So example, 35 by 25. And now we will divide with this fraction. 35 divided by 5, 25 divided by 5. What we got? 7 by 5. We got 7 by 5. Okay, so m is equal to 5 is what here? This one is common divisor. Common divisor. Why we are saying that common divisor? Because this is common for both the 35 and 25. Okay, so we are saying that 5 is common divisor, and what we got? 7 by 5. What property what we have to study that? Last and the third property is what? If we have some rational number p by q, okay, and the another rational number we have r by s. We have two rational numbers, p by q and r by s, and we are writing here p by q is equals to r by s. Then what we can do? That p by q is equals to r by s. This means what? This both rational numbers are equal. Okay. So now if we will do cross multiplication, P multiplied with S and Q multiplied with R, we got the equal result. Okay.